Hi, 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 hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Let's continue our discussion of power system in which we discuss previous SSC JEE questions important for RRB exam. Now we will take some previous gate 1 mark questions which are important for RRB JEE exams as well as for your AE and PSUs, like PSUs and IES and gate exams. So now we will deal with the previous gate questions which are important for your RRB and other competitive exams. So first, the question I am choosing, it is a question which is asked in 2014 gate and it is for 1 mark question from set 3. In a long transmission line with R, L, G and C are the resistances, inductance and shunt conductance and capacitance per unit length respectively. The condition for distortionless transmission line, distortionless transmission line is the ratio of resistance to the conductance should be equal to the ratio of inductance to the capacitance. So from this, resistance into capacitance is equal to conductance into length, inductance. So this is the condition which be satisfied for distortionless transmission line. So answer A is the right option for this question. So let's move to the next question. And the question here, it is asked in 2000 gate, it is for 2 marks. But generally nowadays the same question is asking for 1 mark in PSUs like Transco and Gencos. Okay, let's see the question here. The corona losses on a particular system at 50 heads is 1 kilowatt per kilometer per phase. The corona losses at 60 heads will be, so we know the corona losses is proportional to frequency. The corona losses PC is proportional to F plus 25. So this is the formula here. So based on this formula, let me take P2 by P1 is equal to F2 plus 25 divided by F1 plus 25. So this is the actual formula here. Here, what are the values of P1? P1 they given, it is a 1 kilowatt per kilometer per phase, this is the value they given, and P2 we need to find here. F2 value it is given as 60 hedges, and F1 it will be how much? So it will be 50 hedges, because F1 they mentioned here. So if we substitute the values, all the values, so P2 is equal to F2 value 60 plus 25 divided by how much? 50 plus 25, so into 1. So 1 kilowatt per kilometer per phase, it is going to be 85 divided by 75 into 1. So answer will be 1.13 kilowatt per kilometer per phase. So answer is a D, is a right answer among all the questions here. Okay, and the next question, the question is asked in 2014 gate, it is a 1 mark question from set 3 here. Now for a fully transposed transmission line, so fully transposed transmission lines means, so that lines are going to be changes their positions. Okay, so like this they're going to change again, so transposition of the conductors, right, bundle conductors. For a fully transposed line, transmission line, the positive sequence reactance, that is X1, and a negative sequence reactance, both are equal. Okay, the positive sequence and a negative sequence reactance, both are equal. So option B is the right option for this question here. And the next question, the concept of electrically short, medium and long line is primarily based on, so primarily it is based on the physical length of the line. So if we talk about less than 80 kilometers, we will take it as a short transmission line. In between 80 to 160 we will take it as a medium transmission line, and greater than 160 kilometers we will consider it as a long transmission line. So these are the concepts based on the physical length of the line. So option B is a right option for this question. Next one, so the parameters of transposed overhead transmission lines are given as self reactance XS is equal to 0.4 ohm per kilometer and mutual reactance XM is 0.1 ohm per kilometer, the positive sequence reactance X1 and zero sequence reactance X0 respectively. So this is the similar kind of question which is asked in AP Transco AP Transco 2019 paper. They asked a similar kind of question here. And this is the question asked in GATE 2005 for 2 marks. Okay, but this in AP Transco it is asked for 1 mark question here. Okay, don't expect that 2 mark question will not be appear in PSUs. It will be appear in the form of 1 mark question. Okay, now the formulas for this one here it is. The positive sequence reactants and the negative sequence reactants both are same. So X1 is equal to X2 is equal to XS minus XM. So 0.4 ohm per kilometer minus 0.1, it is going to be 0.3 ohm per kilometer. And zero sequence reactants are higher compared to positive and negative. So XS plus 2 into XM. So be careful, if you are taking minus sign, you will get wrong answer here. XS is how much? 0.4 plus 2 into 0.1, it is going to be 0.6 ohm per kilometer. So be careful here, don't take minus sign here. Okay, now the answer from these options, D is a right option for this question. Okay, so we'll move to the next question here. Next question: consider a long wire line composed of solid round conductors. The radius of the both the conductors is 0.25 centimeters. It is given. The distance between the centers is L meters. If the distance is doubled, the inductance per unit length. So inductance per unit length. So L is directly proportional to natural logarithm of distance between the conductor by radius here. Now what they are doing is, if the distance is doubled, so ln of 2D, distance is doubled. Now what will happen, as the distance is doubled, inductance will also increase. But how much? Okay, so inductance increases but does not double. Why? Because it's a natural logarithm here. Okay, so based on this, so increases but not double is a right option for this question. So this question was asked in GATE 2002. It is for 1 mark. Next question: the corona losses can be minimized. So this question was asked in 1999. It's for 1 mark. The same question is repeated in SSE JE. Okay, so in my previous videos I also discussed the same question here, which is also taken from 1 mark from GATE exam. So current density in the conductors is reduced here. Corona losses can be are minimized when current density in the conductors are going to be reduced. So straightforward question we discuss. And next question: for a 50 Hz frequency excitation, a 50 km short power line will be modeled as. So the short 500 Hz frequency excitation, if 50 km short power line will be modeled as a long transmission. Long transmission line, because what is the wavelength of this line? Lambda is equal to V by F, is nothing but 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second divided by frequency is 500 Hz. So it is going to be 600 kilometers. Okay, so 600 kilometers. When the line wavelength of the line is more than 160 kilometers, we will treat that line as a long line. So answer here is long line. And we'll move to the next question here. So last question for this session: the inductance of a power transmission line increases with. So inductance of a power transmission line, as we know, L is proportional to ln of D by R. So when we increase the spacing between the phases, so spacing between the phase conductors, so as the distance between the phase conductor increases, the inductance of a power transmission line will increase. So when increasing the spacing between the phase conductors, so C is the right option for this question here. So thank you friends, thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, please subscribe, share and comment. Thank you, have a nice day.